What's up everybody, Coach Tyler here from PT Pioneer. Today I'm going to be going over the top 10 tips for passing the ACE CPT exam. If you guys have been doing any research already on passing the ACE CPT exam, you probably have found out that only 65% of test takers pass on the first try. This means that one in every three people that start studying for it are going to fail the ACE CPT test. Overall, that's a huge number, which makes the ACE CPT exam one of the hardest in the industry. By using these top 10 secrets to pass the ACE CPT exam, you will have a much higher chance of passing the exam on your first time around. So these top 10 secrets are going to be broken up into two general categories. The first five secrets are going to be things that you definitely need to study out of the textbook to have the best chance of passing. Now the second five secrets are going to be basically five study techniques that I use with my students so that they can better memorize the material and keep it in their long-term memory and be able to recall it easier when they're taking the exam. So if you find this helpful afterwards, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. So I'm assuming that you guys are watching this video already on my site, PT Pioneer. But if you happen to be on YouTube right now, I'll leave a link in the description down below so you can access free ACE study guides, ACE practice tests, and ACE flashcards on my website. And also make sure to give this a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you find this helpful. So let's jump right into the very first secret for passing the ACE CPT exam. For the first five secrets of things that you actually need to study for the ACE CPT exam, all of them are super important, but pay special attention to secret number four and secret number five, as that's gonna be worth more questions on the exam compared to the other ones. Okay, so secret number one is, it's crucial to know the postural imbalances and understand the many postural assessments that ACE use. Now, this is gonna account for approximately 8 questions out of the 150 multiple choice questions on the ACE CPT exam. So out of all of the postural assessments, you need to pay attention to three primary ones. And they are the foot and ankle pronation, interiorly rotated pelvis, and rounded shoulders and forward head. For each of these, you need to memorize which muscles are underactive or weak and which muscles are overactive and tight. Okay, on to secret number two. You need to pay a lot of attention to chapter 7. There's a ton of questions that come out of this chapter alone. This chapter is all about understanding how to assess a client for functional movement. And not only is this extremely important for the ACE CPT exam, but it's also extremely crucial for when you're an actual personal trainer, you need to have this information memorized, not just for the exam, but for real life situations. Okay, let's head right over to ACE study secret number three. Instead of the first two tips where they were things that you need to focus on, this is something that you don't need to pay too much attention to. And these are, do not stress the muscle actions, and this includes the origins and insertions of all the muscles. Obviously, this is a ton of information to memorize, and this is one of the hardest things that people have trouble trying to memorize all this information, and when it really boils down to it, you're probably only going to see maybe two questions like this on the exam. So the time spent studying all this information towards the payout in terms of how well you do on the exam is very little. I definitely recommend focusing a lot more of your time on the over and underactive muscle of the postural assessments compared to memorizing all the muscle actions and origins and insertions. But here's a quick tip of something that you should definitely memorize in terms of muscle actions is you need to know what the rectus femoris does. Okay, on to secret number four for the ACPT. So just like secret number three, secret number four is something that you don't really need to pay too much attention to, and that is chapter 12 and 13, because practically zero questions on the ACPT exam come from these chapters. But as a personal trainer, obviously I still recommend you guys go through that, read through those chapters and trying to learn as much as you possibly can, because for real world situations, you're actually gonna need this information, but for passing the exam, they just don't pull too many questions from these two chapters. So overall, do not stress out too much about chapter 12 and 13. Okay, let's move on to secret number five. Secret number five is all about memorizing the whole table of 6.1 in your textbook. Table 6.1 talks about the risk factors for cardiovascular disease. Overall, in the history of ACE, they've spent a lot of time and pulled a lot of questions just from this chart alone. You can expect to see as much as 6 or more questions just from the single chart. You need to memorize all of the positive risk factors for CVD as well as all of the defining criteria as well. All of the positive risk factors include family history, cigarettes, being sedentary, obesity, hypertension, prediabetes, and dyslipidemia. Now I know in the section of defining criteria there's a lot of information, but just read over and read over until you totally have this thing down. Okay, yeah, so those are the first five seekers for stuff that you should study or not study for the ACE CPT. Now, the second five seekers are going to be all about study techniques that I highly recommend that you guys use in order to have an easier time memorizing this material that you're studying. Okay, so let's go over the first study technique. And the first study technique is to use a study guide. I can't recommend this enough. I see so many people trying to memorize every single page from the 500 plus pages of the ACE CPT manual. Now, I've seen so many people try to study this way and end up failing the test in the end because they're just overwhelmed with information. Now, something that breaks that 500 pages down into something more digestible, like 50 to 100 pages, is a lot easier to take in and study through. If you don't have a study guide, you're just going to be going through page by page and not knowing what's important to memorize and what's important to skip. A good place to start, guys, is on my website, PT Pioneer. I have a free study guide, flashcards, and practice tests. So if you guys are currently watching this on YouTube, I'll leave a link in the description down below. Okay, on to study technique number two. And that is to use spaced repetition flashcards to help you memorize difficult topics and lots of definitions. Now let me explain what spaced repetition flashcards are real fast. Basically, normal flashcards, you'll have something like, what is a postural imbalance? And you'll have the definition of it on the other side. You'll have hundreds or even thousands of these flashcards, but the only problem is the flashcards that you know really well are going to show up with the same frequency as the ones that you don't know very well. Now with spaced repetition flashcard setting, you get to judge how well you know a card. Now the program is going to learn from that, and it's going to show you your flashcards that you don't know very well repeatedly until you completely have it memorized. On the other hand, the cards that you know really well are not going to show up with too much frequency because you already know them very well. Now this is going to make your studying a lot more efficient, and it's going to save you a lot of time overall because you're going to be focusing your studying on the stuff you don't know very well while skipping the stuff that you already have memorized. A couple good applications that do spaced repetition setting are Brainscape and Anki. Okay guys, on to ACE study technique number three. And this is to use practice tests before you end up taking the real exam. I can't tell you how many students of mine come back after failing and tell me that they never even tried one practice test. By not trying one practice test, you don't actually know how effective your studying has been up to that point. Now, if these students had taken some practice tests before taking the real test, they might have realized that they weren't yet ready and spent more time studying before setting a test date. Overall, a general rule of thumb I have is that if you could take 3 full practice tests and score on average 85% or more on them, you should have a pretty good feeling to know that you're going to pass the real exam. Okay guys, on to study technique number 4. And this is all about setting a schedule and sticking to it. So depending on how much knowledge of exercise science you already have under your belt, you might want to set a schedule between 4, 6, or 16 weeks of studying. But it's so funny because a lot of people do not set any sort of schedule or don't make any study blueprint for themselves, and they end up procrastinating to the very end where they need to end up cramming in the last week. And these are the people that typically end up failing the exam the first try. So I recommend from the get-go creating a blueprint for studying and trying to set time aside every day, or maybe like a few days a week where you set aside a few hours of studying and stick to that schedule. Now this is the best way to make sure you don't procrastinate to the last second where you're forced to cram. But if you're currently watching this video and you've been procrastinating the whole time and you only have a week before your exam date, I highly recommend picking up a cram guide. This will help you focus on exactly what you need to study and give you the best chance to pass the test. Okay guys, on to study technique number 5 and secret number 10 overall. Now overall, this is one of the most important things that my students use in order to not only pass the test, but to memorize the information in their long-term memory bank. Okay, study technique number 5 is to use mnemonics to help remember difficult concepts and topics from the textbook. Now, although the study technique might seem weird, it's actually one of the most helpful things my students have used in order to memorize the material and remember it long-term. Because to be honest, it's great to memorize stuff in order to pass the exam, but if you want to be a good personal trainer, you're going to have to remember this information and you're going to have to keep it in your long-term memory bank so that when you're working with clients 3, 4, 5 years down the road, you won't have to refer back to the book to see which muscles are overactive and underactive because you already have it memorized. So one big tip I have for you guys is to make your mnemonics as weird as you possibly can and as funny as you possibly can in order to make it as memorable as you can and to remember it for the rest of your life. So one example I have for you guys is a mnemonic I made in order to remember the three factors that influence exercise participation. And those are personal attributes, environmental factors, and physical activity factors. And the mnemonic I made for that is purple elegant plumbers agonized. Now what I like to imagine are these really elegant plumbers, and typically you don't see an elegant plumber that walks into your house, but they're totally purple, like covered in purple goo or something like that, and they're completely agonized because of this fact. Now creating something like this that's super out there and out of this world is definitely a lot more memorable than making something just really boring that you're gonna forget probably 2 seconds after you think about it. So this is one of the biggest things I use with my students in order for them to memorize all of the overactive and underactive muscles. Now it's funny because a lot of people that don't use mnemonics still memorize the information for the exam, but then 2 weeks later they've completely forgotten about it. So not only are these mnemonics fantastic for memorizing and pulling this information out of your head during the exam, but you're also going to have this information with you for years to come. Okay everybody, so that is it, all 10 secrets for passing the ACPT exam. If you guys can please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if this video was helpful, that would be awesome. Now if you guys are currently on my website, down below I have a free study guide, practice test questions, and flashcards for you guys to use. But if you're currently on YouTube, I'll have a link in the description down below so you guys can access these free study materials as well. Okay everybody, that concludes my video. Good luck with all the studying and get out there and crush the ACPT test.